Hello children, welcome to AIIMS India's online classes, biology session. Excretion, the waste disposing system, part 4. Up to now, we have studied the human excretory system, its parts and the functions, especially the structure of nephron, and the process of filtration, urine formation. We are discussing now the urine formation and the composition of urine in the today's class. In the last class, urine formation is completed. Let us briefly recall. Urine formation includes glomerular filtration, tubular reabsorption and tubular secretion. These are the three main steps. What is glomerular filtration or ultrafiltration? It occurs because the pressure of the blood flowing in the glomerular capillaries is higher than the pressure of the filtrate in the Bowman's capsule. Okay? Glomerular filtration or ultrafiltration occurs because the pressure of the blood flowing in the glomerular capillaries is higher than the glomerular capillaries. How the glomerular capillaries are formed? By efferent arteriole here. Okay. It is glomerular capillaries is higher than the pressure of the filtrate in the Bowman's capsule. This is the Bowman's capsule. Okay. Next, it does not require the expenditure of energy by kidney cells. The quantity of glomerular filtrate formed each minute in all the nephrons of both kidneys, it is called glomerular filtrate. GFR, glomerular filtration rate, it is called glomerular filtration rate. What is glomerular filtration rate? The quantity of glomerular filtrate formed each minute in all the nephrons of both the kidneys is called glomerular filtration rate. In a normal person, this glomerular filtration rate is about 125 ml per minute. How much ml? 125 ml per minute. This is about the first step, glomerular filtration. The second step we have studied, tubular reabsorption. It is the second process in the formation of urine from filtrate. So here, as much as 99% of the material in the filtrate is reabsorbed, preventing the loss of water, essential nutrients and ions from the body. It is very essential step, tubular reabsorption. As a consequence, urine contains mostly the waste materials and excess water. So after filtration, the urine contains only excess water and waste materials. So about 65% of the glomerular filtrate is normally reabsorbed in the which part? The proximal convoluted tubule, 65% before it entering into the loop of Henle. Okay, so what are the substances reabsorbed? Glucose, amino acids, vitamins, hormones, sodium, potassium, chlorides, phosphates, bicarbonates, much of the water and some urea from the filtrate are absorbed. Okay, some of the urea is also absorbed. The sulfates and creatine are not reabsorbed. Sodium and potassium are reabsorbed by primary active transport. Glucose and amino acids are reabsorbed by secondary active transport. Water is reabsorbed by osmosis. Chloride ions, urea and other solutes are reabsorbed by diffusion. See here. Different processes are involved in the reabsorption: diffusion, osmosis, secondary active transport, primary active transport. These are all the process which involved in the reabsorption, tubular reabsorption. Okay. Now the filtrate is isotonic to blood plasma. The filtrate which is formed after the tubular reabsorption is equal to, the composition is equal to the composition of the blood plasma. Okay. Next, in the descending limb of loop of Henle, water is reabsorbed due to increasing osmolality. Here, in the descending loop of Henle, descending limb of loop of Henle, water is reabsorbed due to increasing osmolality of interstitial fluid, means the fluid which is present between the cells. Sodium and other solutes are not reabsorbed here. The filtrate becomes hypertonic to blood plasma. The ascending limb of loop of Henle is impermeable to water but permeable to potassium. Ascending. Okay, the ascending limb is permeable to potassium chloride and sodium ions, and partially permeable to urea. So the filtrate becomes hypotonic. In the descending limb, hypertonic, more concentrated, and in the descending limb, hypotonic. Okay, hypotonic to blood plasma. Then next, the DCT, distal convoluted tubule. In DCT, there is a active reabsorption of sodium ions from the filtrate. Here some hormones are involved. Okay, that is the influence of aldosterone, which helps in the water. It is absorbed here under the influence of vasopressin. We have come across vasopressin, or it is also called as a antidiuretic hormone, which is secreted by posterior lobe of pituitary gland. So this makes the filtrate isotonic to blood plasma. Once again, the filtrate formed here is similar to the composition of blood plasma. And finally, this is in the collecting duct. In the collecting duct, further reabsorption of water takes place. Now the filtrate becomes hypertonic to blood plasma, more concentrated. The sodium is reabsorbed in the collecting duct under the influence of a hormone, aldosterone. The filtrate is now called as a urine. So thus, the urine is hypertonic, means more concentrated than blood plasma. And finally, tubular secretion. The tubular secretion refers to the addition of selected materials from the blood to the ultrafiltrate, and it increases its volume. So it occurs mainly in the active transport, which takes place in the distal convoluted tubule and proximal convoluted tubule. Okay, so finally the urine is formed. Let us continue the composition of urine. Now, urine is a transparent fluid produced by urinary system or excretory system. This urine has amber color due to the presence of a pigment called urochrome. Okay, pale yellow in color, light yellow in color. The composition of the normal urine varies considerably depending on several factors. For example, taking a protein rich diet will result in the more formation of urea in the urine. Okay, because proteins are made up of amino acids. These ammonia or these amino acids, they are converted to urea. Because ammonia is more toxic, so it is converted to urea in the liver. So then it comes to the kidneys for filtration. So if you consume more proteinaceous food, the urine contains more urea. So urine contains 96% of water, 2.5% of organic substances. Organic substances means urea, uric acid, proteins like creatine, creatinine, and water-soluble vitamins, hormones, and oxalates. So vitamins and hormones, they are proteins only, okay, containing amino acids. So and oxalates, these are all the organic substances present in the urine. And it also contains 1.5% of inorganic solutes, means some salts like sodium chloride, potassium sulfate, magnesium, calcium, iodine. These are all the inorganic solutes which are present in the urine. So urine is acidic in the beginning but becomes alkaline. Acidic means slightly acidified. The pH is less than 7 in the beginning. But it becomes alkaline, means basic, on standing, means storing, due to the decomposition of urea to form ammonia. So if urine is stored for a long time, what happens? Again that urea is converted to ammonia. Okay? So due to that, what happens? Acidic becomes basic. The pH increases greater than 7. Next. So here what happens finally? The expulsion of the urine from the urinary bladder, it is called as micturition. And it is a reflex process, but in grown-up children and adults, it can be controlled voluntarily to some extent. Okay? So actually, that mechanism is called counter-current mechanism. The counter-current mechanism means the fluid flows in opposite direction in the two sides of the loop, down one side and up the other. It helps to maintain a concentration gradient in the medullary interstitial fluid, which helps in the easy absorption of water from the filtrate present in collecting duct. So that what happened? The concentration of the filtrate urine is increased. Okay. The regulation of kidney function depends upon some hormones also. Sometimes kidney failure occurs. So during the kidney failure, this method, what do you call artificial kidney? The complete reversible kidney, artificial kidney is a complete reversible kidney. So here the transparent fluid umbilicular, it is formed. Okay, so urine contains this. What happens if both the kidneys fail completely? The complete and irreversible kidney failure is called the stage, is called end stage. End stage renal disease, ESRD, end stage renal disease. If kidneys stop working completely, our body is filled with extra water and waste products. So this condition is called uremia. Uremia. Uremia is the condition when the kidney failure occurs, the body is filled with extra water and waste products. What do you call that condition? Uremia. Okay, especially the limbs, hands or feet, they swell. Okay, you feel, means the condition, the person feel tired and weak because the body needs clean blood to function properly. Is there any solution for to this problem? Let us know about the artificial kidney. The only solution is dialysis process. Okay? The kidneys are very vital organs for survival. Several factors like infections, injury, very high blood pressure, very high blood sugar, or restricted blood flow to kidneys, or any blockages which prevent the flow of blood to the kidneys. These are all leads to accumulation of poisonous wastes, means nitrogenous wastes in the body, become toxic, and even it may lead to death. So dialysis machine is used to filter the blood of a person when both the kidneys are damaged. The process is called hemodialysis. Hemodialysis. Okay, in this process, blood is taken out from the main artery, mixed with an anticoagulant. Okay, so what is hemodialysis and how the process done? In this process, the blood is taken out from the main artery, mixed with an anticoagulant. What is an anticoagulant? Which prevent the clotting of blood. So as soon as the blood is exposed outside, immediately what happens? It will clot. So that is a natural phenomenon. Blood clotting mechanism is there. So to prevent the coagulation of blood, some anticoagulants like heparin is added, mixed, and then pumped into the apparatus called dialyzer, dialysis machine. Okay. Next, so this is the dialyzer. So here the blood is taken from the artery, from the main artery, and it is placed or passed into the dialyzer. So some anticoagulant is mixed with this blood to prevent the coagulation, and is passed into the apparatus called dialyzer. In this apparatus, the blood flows through channels or tubes. Here you can see here. So these tubes are embedded in a dialyzing fluid. This yellow color one is the dialyzing fluid. Okay, these tubes are embedded in the dialyzing fluid. The membrane separates the blood flowing inside the tube and the dialyzing fluid or dialysis, which has the same composition as that of plasma, except the nitrogenous wastes. The dialyzing fluid is similar to the composition of plasma. The difference is, in plasma some nitrogenous wastes are also present, but here there are no nitrogenous wastes. Okay. So this process, dialysis, okay, can be done. As the nitrogenous wastes are absent in the dialyzing fluids, so these substances from the blood, so nitrogenous wastes are absent in the dialyzing fluid, so these substances from the blood move out freely, and thereby cleaning the blood of its wastes can be done. Okay, blood removed for cleansing. So you can see another figure. So this is the dialyzer. Okay, and here the clean blood, after cleaning, that blood is again passed into the body, returned to the body. So blood removed from the cleaning, removed for cleaning. So this is the blood. It goes into the dialyzer, where it is filtered, and again it is passed into the body. Okay, these substances from the blood move out freely, and thereby cleaning the blood of its wastes. This process is called dialysis, and this is similar to the function of a kidney, but is different as there is no reabsorption involved. Here there is no reabsorption involved. The cleaned blood is pumped back to the body through a vein, superficial blood vessel, after adding antiheparin. Next, each dialysis session lasts for 3 to 6 hours. It requires 3 to 6 hours. This method has been using for thousands of uremic kidney failure patients all over the world. The same process, dialysis process, is used. Okay. And is there any long-term solution for the kidney failure patients? Okay, this dialysis process is done, nice, but it's a costly process. How long it is done, so long the person can survive. There is no compensation because kidneys, both the kidneys are failed. So is there any solution for the kidney failure patients? Yes, only transplantation, kidney transplantation. The first kidney transplantation was performed between the identical twins in 1954 by Dr. Charles Hafnagel. He was a surgeon at Washington or USA. In India, the first kidney transplantation was done on the 1st December 1971 at the Christian Medical College, Vellore. Vellore means Tamil Nadu. Okay. So there is the only solution for long-term solution for the kidney failure, that is kidney transplantation. So let us know about the kidney transplantation. The best long-term solution for the kidney failure or acute renal problems, renal failures, is kidney transplantation. A functioning kidney is used in transplantation from a donor. Donor means a person who donates the kidney, preferably a close relative. The kidney that is received by a recipient must be a good match to his body. The kidney that is received by a recipient must be a good match to his body. To minimize the chances of rejection of transplanted kidney by the immune system of the recipient. Okay, so actually kidney transplantation is not only kidney, any organ transplantation is not an easy process. There are several steps. The blood group has to match, the tissue has to match. So that's why for kidney transplantation or any transplantation, preferably close relatives, donors must be selected from the close relatives. Okay. The modern clinical procedures have increased the success rate of such a complicated technique. It is a complicated technique. So nowadays the process of organ donation helps a lot kidney failure patients. The organs are collected from the brain dead patients. Okay. Then transplanted to the recipient. Recipient means the person who receive. So there are a few questions are there. Where the transplanted kidney fixed in the body? Fixed in the body of the kidney failure patient. Okay. Or what about the failure kidneys? Can donor survive her life or his life with a single kidney without any complications? Okay, these are all the questions arise. No doubt, one kidney is sufficient to survive because the function, one kidney, but a little load is there on that kidney, but no problem. The person can survive, can lead a normal life with one kidney. So kidney transplantation, that's the reason the donors are selected from the brain dead people. Okay, whenever the accident occurs, they immediately, if the relatives accept, then donor's kidney can be taken. Okay, where it is placed means or a required position in the abdominal cavity, just beneath the failure kidney. Okay, it may be arranged. the new kidney. The old or damaged kidneys may be removed surgically. Okay, these are all done. Next, other pathways are there. Accessory excretory organs. Okay, this is about the kidneys functions and the kidney failure. Usually, the disorders of excretory system. If you take kidney stones, that is called renal calculus. It is formed by the precipitation of uric acid or oxalate. It causes severe colic pain in the back, spreading down to thighs. The stone may pass into the ureter or urinary bladder, may grow and result in severe pain or blockade. Okay, that is called kidney stone. Next, glomerulonephritis. It is the inflammation of glomeruli due to injury or bacterial infections or toxins or due to some drugs. Glomerulonephritis, nephrons die. Next, uremia. Uremia means accumulation. It is a common problem. Accumulation of the urea in the blood due to the malfunctioning of the kidney. Highly harmful and usually a consequence of kidney or renal failure may occur in such patients. Urea can be removed by hemodialysis. Okay, kidney or renal failure. It is a medical condition in which the kidney fail to adequately filter the waste products from the blood. Hemodialysis should be started after diagnosis is done. In hemodialysis, blood is drained from an artery into a dialyzing unit. Just now.